to do. So what we've had here is an aircraft that's on takeoff, has had a problem, has lost control, and has crashed on takeoff. The way we're reflecting that in terms of the scenario is that this fire simulator that you saw on fire earlier on is the front end of the aircraft, which has caught fire, and of which you probably expect some quite severe, if not some deaths, as far as the casualties are concerned. And then reflected by the old blue bus is the back end of the aircraft, because the aircraft is broken into, where you'd expect possibly some lesser casualties. And as you've seen wandering around here, people were in shock, walking wounded, and etc. The way our crash plan works here, and this is a military airfield still, so it's mandated by the Military Aviation Authority, we have to have an in-date crash plan and an effective crash plan. But as you can imagine, given all the assets that are required, it's very much a joint venture between the MOD and also the government of Gibraltar, is that my assets, which are here on the airfield, were what we would call the first response. So as you've seen, the airfield's fire section have arrived. The yellow wagon is on the initial medical response, and then the teams that are here bringing some of the equipment that we would need to deal with the fire, so such as the additional hoses, tentage will go up, etc. We will then expect, and what should hopefully be happening fairly shortly, obviously the City Fire Brigade and the RGP, along with the ambulance, the GHA ambulance services, will be arriving. They'll have had the call from air traffic and will be responding effectively as our, for want of a better phrase, our follow-on forces. Then also what we're hoping to happen is, rather than, as you've seen with the people wandering along the road, rather than having a lot of people who are obviously well trained and keen to get involved in this, and therefore a lot of blue light traffic going up and down the runway and potentially causing additional accidents, is down at the western hangar is where our emergency RVP point is, and that's where all the blue light activity will collate. And then there'll be a communication between that area and the incident control commander there to bring forward the assets that are required, or they assess are required for the incident itself. So they may well say, "I knew we don't have enough fire engines here. I need another fire engine, or we've got a significant number of serious casualties. Send me three ambulances." And we want to see how that interaction takes place as well. And so that's basically the first two stages of what we have here. And of course, as you'll be well aware of, one of the additional complications that we have here in Gibraltar is the fact that we're going to have to try and coordinate that with the fact that the barriers are down now, and we'll soon be in a position where we'll potentially have a lot of gridlock around the town. So again, the ambulances have to get from the hospital, the City Fire Brigade have got to get from their base, etc. So there's an element that the RGP will also be practicing here today, which is the traffic management plan, to allow the blue light services to get here, hopefully quite quickly, and then also being able to facilitate the removal of the casualties with the ambulances down to the GHA.